Welcome to the Saptak Archives podcast. This is a new initiative by Saptak, and our objective is to propagate our musical heritage and to build a vibrant community around it. We do hope you will enjoy the curated music we bring to you.
Welcome to the Saptak podcast. My name is Smith Dharia, and I'll be sharing some beautiful Hindustani classical music recordings with you, alongside some perspective on the music to help enhance your listening pleasure. I feel when discussing something like music, in which things can be so abstract and intangible, it's nice to have some common constant between the different pieces of music we talk about and listen to. So, I thought it'd be nice to focus on a particular bandish and see how each rendition of it differs, and if those differences give us any insight into that particular artist's aesthetic. I've always felt that Rag Nand is fairly unvarying in terms of its melodic form and has a set way in which one tends to move up and down within it. So, this narrower playing field of Rag Nand can be a good way to observe the possibilities of creative approaches of an artist and see how their personalities drive the music. We'll be listening to recordings of the bandish Dhundu Bare Saiya. So for listeners who are completely unfamiliar with this rag and this bandish, here's a recording of the same. Also, this particular recording is not sung with any taal accompaniment, so the melodic aspect of both the rag and the bandish are very easy to observe. This is a recording of Shrimati Shruti Sadolikar. So let's listen to Dhundu Bare Saiya in Rag Nand.
Bare
You may have noticed that in broad terms, Rag Nand tends to move like this. Ga ma pa dha ni pa pa dha ma pa ga ga ma dha pa re sa ga ga ma ma pa. You must have also observed that although there was no tabla accompaniment to the music, Shrutiji's development of the bandish was so suggestive of the temporal aspect. This is an identifiable feature of the Jaipur Atroli Gharana, where every phrase is syncopated against the steady lay of the tal. Not to suggest that musicians of other gharanas don't do this, but Jaipur musicians particularly highlight this. So, keeping these things in mind, let's listen to a couple of archival recordings. The first recording we'll listen to is Surshri Kesar by Kerkars. But before we talk about the music, here's a short clip of Professor B.R. Devdar discussing Kesar Bhai.
So, temperament is your individual, how do you learn to play? Now, if you say how much you can learn to play, you can't say that it's not in the morning. Now, Hira Bhai. Hira Bhai says, I'll help you. मुझसे को दया करो इस तरह से आएगा मैं केसर भाई इज एब्सोल्युटली आई वांट टू नो सिंगिंग यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड क्यों कि इनको सीखते ही है के बाद एक इतने बड़े 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 मिल गए तो इनको लाइफ में नीड जिसको कहते हैं कोई जरूरत है या किसी की ये प्रसंग आया ही नहीं तकलीफ नहीं तो शी वाज लाइक दैट सुनना है तो सुनो नहीं तो निकल जाओ ये इनकी एटीट्यूड थी गाने That is a temperament.
Right, correct.
So temperament plays a good deal.
Very true, very true.
Although Devdarji's statements on Kesar Bhai's life may not be accurate, having interacted with her on various occasions and heard her live many times, he may give us a hint as to what her personality was like. Every time I listen to her music, I get a sense of grandiosity, and it excites me to see how well each avartan tells a story in itself. So keeping in mind all that we know about Raghunand, let's see how Kesarbai tells her tale.
Yeah.
Kesarbai's music is so well modulated, and there's so much to learn from the way she punctuates each phrase. So to contrast this, I'd like to play you a short clip of sections of taans from another artist's recording. This is Lakshmibai Jadhav. The recording quality is poor, so please excuse that. Contrast to Lakshmibai, it almost seems that Kesarbai is two paces ahead of the present musical moment and has preempted the sum much before us. I guess that when an artist is able to present her idea of perfection, it makes us feel that this was so obvious. But there's a great amount of deliberation and years of gleaning involved. So let's finish with a recording of this artist called Azambai. She too trained under Jaipur masters, and as you will see, is effortless in her vocal abilities. She does an unusual thing around the mukhra by bringing in the nishad by doing
Dhundu Bare Saiya.
So do listen for that. Her pace is the fastest I have heard for this bandish, and I think that takes away some of the stateliness that Kesarbai's rendition has. But I guess it's these diverse tastes and temperaments and choices that bring variety to these age-old constructs of rag and taal. So let's listen to Azambai singing Ragnand Dhundu Bare Saiya.
Dundu bare kya, dundu bare kya, dundu bare kya.